weird. I can hear the other guys through the thing. Ah, run away. You. Honestly, I like that. This is actually the reason why no one likes the. I think the hookshot's the reason why no one likes the boomerang or no one uses it. It's because it's like the super upgrade, which is also why they give you the ability to get the magic boomerang a lot earlier, so that you can have something that's kind of like the hookshot, despite its inability to attack anything. What was that? Screw you, thingy. I should just grind up hearts, but you know, I don't freaking have the money for that. What's in here? Money, money. I don't need money. I can't really think of where I'm supposed to go. Oh yeah. Duh, there's another way out. There's the up passage that I totally didn't think about. Yeah, why didn't I do that? Cause this one, yep. Yep, yep, yep. This is called Hans being stupid and tired in the morning. Despite having plenty of sleep and nothing to do. Alright, here we have lots of this crud. Arrows, bombs, money. You know, usual necessities, unless you're me. In which case, you don't need them. You don't even use them. I think this is the last one. Yep, after this is a hallway. I don't want to do this one. This next bit is difficult. It's not fun. Especially if you screw up, because I want to get into the next room over. Not gonna happen. Not gonna happen well. Can I get you? Screw you then, eh? Damn tektites. Go away. I think they're tektites. They might be water spiders. They look more like tektites though, because they're on the water. So, blue tektites? Blue tektites. Yeah, that's the name for it. We're gonna do this though and hope it works. Does Quake work on water? Yes, it does. Woohoo. And boss room. Is there any chews in the ground? Nope. Alright, now this boss. I actually don't know what to call it. But, as you can see, it's this. Which is why I don't know what to call it. Because it's kind of like normal. Except, you know, it's not. Well, it's kind of like the one in the water temple. Except, it's in two dimensions and it's not an amoeba. It's surrounded by weird cloud things. And I can't hear anything. I might. Yeah. That's not fun. Alright, where are you at? No! You were in the air! How did you hit me? God, I never die on this boss. Ever! Especially when he's jumping in the air. Don't attack from the top. Is this gonna work? I hope that. Yes! Whoa! It's over now. And that was really short. I wonder how quickly that went by. Either way, that's actually all I got time for. Well, no, that's not all I got time for. I got a little bit more, so I can do a little bit. But yeah, we rescued you. Great. Okay, was that? Okay, Ganon is the evil guy again. Oh, remember that you have magical powers, which only the hero can make the most of. There are some other magical warping points, like the one you found. By using them, you can go between the two worlds and find the evils hidden in. Okay. Yeah, I get it, but that's just kind of, you know, generic. I want something new. Okay, thanks again for another generic story. And with that, my favorite item in the game is here. It even causes damage. But yeah, other than that, we're actually kind of done in the Dark World for a bit. Because we have to go through the Light World to get where we need to go next. Because if you saw, in order to get the Dark Kakariko Town, you needed to, wait a second. Can I get up here? Can I do this? In order to get into Dark Kakariko Town, we needed an item that we didn't have in order to lift up a rock we can't lift. We can! What is this? What does this say? Hold up the Master Sword and you'll get the Magic of Bombos. Oh, and just to show what it is, that's what it does. It murders things. And with that, we're actually in the Light World now, so let us be off. Yeah, let us be off. Let's use this. I will be back where we should be, or where I need to go next, because there's some things I'm missing. And we're back, and as you can see, we're also at the top of Death Mountain near this thing again, where we were told to hold up the Master Sword so we can get the Power of Aether. Now, we actually need this to complete the game, because this is one of the two medallions that we need to enter the last two dungeons of the game. Well, technically the last two, but I won't be doing them in that order, just because I don't really like the fifth one a whole lot. So anyway, that's all it does is it freezes strong enemies and kills weak ones. But like everything else, it uses magic, so be careful, because you never want to be caught without that. Another thing we want to show you is I think it's this cave here. No, it's the other one. The cave is in the cave is in the Dark World. Yeah. Will I have enough? Oh, I hope to God I do. Will I make it? I hope I do. Because this will be a very bad ending. Very bad start to this video. No, I'm not gonna make it. Shit. Oh. Damn you. No, I can. Oh, I forgot about that. I thought I only had one. Well, that's pretty awesome. Oh, thank God. Anyways, this cave here, it kills you to get there. But watch. It's fucking jerk. Because it gives you the Cane of Berna. Which means when you swing it, nothing can hurt you. Until you unequip it. And then, yeah. But nothing can hurt you. At all. You can walk over spikes, run into stuff, everything. I mean, it's just that good. Now, let's go to the light world again. And travel down the mountain. What's that? And we're gonna go to Kakaroko Town. Because that's the last place we need to go. Because there's not a... Yeah. Oh, can't go this way because can't lift this rock yet. But there's a portal right up there. So, screw you. Thank you. I know I'm missing something. Usually I'm not this disorganized with this game. Pretty sure I'm as far as I can get, or as far as I want to get right now. I won't go hunting until after the next dungeon I want to do. Simply because I don't think it'll work well that way. I don't know what items I need, what I need to lift things, what I don't need to lift things, what I need to burn. I don't really know. Okay, and now we're in the dark world. And just like in the human world, I can't go lifting things. Can't go lifting that rock yet. Go, bye. No, Yeah. Okay. And here's Dark Kakaroko Town. Or as people call it, the Village of Outcasts. And if you don't have money, don't be here. What is this? Really? No, go away. I don't want to be part of that. What's in here? What is this, hey? Oh, 300. You know, whatever, I don't use them anyways. I got enough for the end of the game. There's not really that many puzzles that require my attention. Can't lift this up. Can't go over there yet. There's not really much we can do. What is in here, eh? Wow, I haven't seen a normal person in a few hundred years. Let me talk to you for a while. Did you know about the gargoyle statue in the village? People say they can hear a girl calling for help under the statue. Isn't that a strange story? Yeah, well, it would be, except there's a crystal in the middle of this town, right where the gargoyle statue should be. So I think there's a girl in there. But I'm not sure. Pretty sure. Alright, we are taking health potions. Lots of those. And then go over here, bomb a wall, maybe we can bust it down with a... No, we can't do that with a hammer. We can do this. What is that? They're moving things. Oh, hello, what is in here? Money! More money I don't need. I would wish I'd get this when I'm flat broke. That would... But, nah, that's just the way cookie crumbs, I guess. Oh, there's a treasure game over there. And a gargoyle statue. So yeah, I think that I'm gonna cut it off here, because we're about to enter a new dungeon. And, So yeah, I will see you guys later when we take on the, well, this is called the Thieves' Hideout, or that's what I call it. So yeah, I'll see you guys then. Bye.